Today, we're going to talk about dipole-dipole forces. Dipole-dipole forces are a type of intermolecular force. This means they occur between molecules, as opposed to within them. Dipole-dipole forces occur between two polar molecules. Before we get into dipole-dipole forces, let's review what a polar molecule is. A polar molecule occurs when there's an unequal distribution of electrons. Let's take hydrofluoric acid as an example. Hydrofluoric acid is composed of one atom of hydrogen and one atom of fluorine, which share an electron. The electron orbits both hydrogen and fluorine, but it spends much longer orbiting fluorine because fluorine is more electronegative. That means that fluorine attracts an electron more strongly. This gives hydrogen a partial positive charge and fluorine a partial negative charge, making that molecule polar. You can determine how electronegative an element is using the acronym Funkelbrush. This stands for fluorine, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, bromine, iodine, sulfur, carbon, and hydrogen. Fluorine is the most electronegative element in the periodic table. Let's use nitrogen trichloride as an example. Nitrogen trichloride is composed of one nitrogen atom and three chlorine atoms. Because the chlorine atoms are more electronegative than the nitrogen atoms, all the chlorine atoms have a partial negative charge, and all the nitrogen atoms have a partial positive charge. The partial positive and partial negative charges are attracted to each other. This attraction between positive and negative atoms is what we call a dipole-dipole force. Dipole-dipole forces are generally weak.